It was a woman, wasn't it?
Noticed while growing up that in the movies all the bullies were the redheads. So it always made it seem like the redheaded boy especially was the vicious, ferocious little rascal.
Men with red hair are uglier than women with red hair.
Yeah, Ron Weasley, Harry Potter.
Oh yeah, yeah, okay.
But he's a good guy.
Yeah, but
he's also a stereotype. He's a loser. He's no good at magic. He's no good with girls.
It's really different from girls with red hair, because girls with their hair are like sassy.
What stereotypes do you have in your mind when you think of a redheaded woman?
Pretty hot.
Yeah, I do it.
What'd you say?
I do it.
You do it.
Redheaded women are more fiery and tempered, I think.
Fiery.
In the bedroom, they're very much more experimental and frisky and a little bit more naughty and dangerous.
Redheads. You know, those soulless, freckled, pale-faced bastards. Redheads. Okay, but is she a natural redhead? I mean, come on. Because she's attractive and looks like she actually has a soul, so it's awkward for me. This fucker, however. Satan much?
In most films these days, redheads fall into two categories. Eccentric and sexy. Not just sexy. Exotic sexy, spicy, dangerous sexy. Even when the women are powerful and enriched characters, they still tend to have stereotypes associated with their character, such as anger issues, violence, evil, daffiness. Princess Fiona from Shrek is an interesting modern contrast, for she plays the perfect princess in search of her happy ending, though still fiery and eccentric, but also the hidden ogre who keeps her red hair in the transformation. Of course, she chooses her ogre self for true love, and because she identifies more with the unprincess-like aspects of her personality, which carry over to her ogre experience, along with that red hair. Over centuries of art and history, there's been a slightly disturbing fascination with red hair. Aristotle described redheads as being emotionally unhousebroken. The Nazis discussed whether red-haired people should be allowed to wed for fear of degenerate offspring. Mary Magdalene developed into a redhead to mark her identity as a reformed prostitute in contrast to the blue-robed Virgin Mary. While most think red hair originated in Scandinavia, Scotland, or Ireland, it in fact started in Central Asia. Its rarity has given rise to a host of stereotypes and myths, from violence to demonic witchcraft. At the height of Europe's witch hunts of the 16th and 17th centuries, women were stripped, shaved, and tortured by witch hunters simply because they were redheads. I can't tell you how many times I've been jokingly asked if I have a soul or if I'll eat theirs. The fetishism and sexualization of redheads increased during the golden age of Hollywood, with stars like Clara Bow associated with humor, vitality, and sexuality. After the decline of her career in the 1930s, Bow was replaced by Lucille Ball, who dyed her hair to adopt Bow's saucy reputation.
The difference is you used to be a brunette, didn't you? Dyed your hair.
A lot you know. My hair is naturally red. Yeah. Isn't it, Ethel?
look, Lucy, let's not add perjury to our other charges.
Ball success in films like I Love Lucy show her hair being popularized as part of her sex appeal and fiery character. In fact, many Hollywood actresses famous for their red hair today are natural blondes or brunettes. According to an analysis of more than 1,700 ads between 8 and 11 p.m. on five evenings, one-third included redheads, half as main characters. This immensely contrasts to the 1 to 2% of natural redheads globally, most of which reside in the United States. There's two proposed reasons for this overrepresentation. One is the association of red with the previously outlined traits, and the other is the activation of reward-seeking in our brains and a sense of novelty. While I acknowledge this reasoning, it does not excuse the prevalent use of offensive and damaging stereotypes.
It really irritates me when South Park would say that red-haired people don't have souls, okay?
We've all seen them on the playground, at the store, walking on the streets. They creep us out and make us feel sick to our stomachs. I'm talking, of course, about ginger kids. Ginger kids are born with a disease which causes very light skin, red hair, and freckles. This disease is called gingivitis.
It pisses me off! Ginger people do have souls, all right? I'm red hair. I have red hair. I got red hair, and I'm proud of it.
It really irritates me. People would say that red-haired people don't have souls. Because we do. We do have souls, all right? And lately, I've been called a ginger. A fat ginger. By everybody at school. Gingers have souls! I go to church. I'm a Christian. You don't know me. You're not God. It pisses me off! Ginger people do have souls, all right?
Redhead discrimination and bullying is a real thing.
Oh, Chloe, don't worry. It's just God punishing you because you're a ginger.
While some newer heroines contain more exciting narratives that either satirize or try to downplay the stereotypes of red hair, the tropes have largely stuck and continue to affect the reception of characters. There's no good stereotypes for gingers. Sex appeal?
You wouldn't be wandering now from door to door.
While associated, it is more in an untouchable, dangerous, risk-filled way, as if actually sleeping with one of those temptresses could be nothing other than regrettable and sinful. There's something wrong with that.